Welcome to Car Comparers. Today we'll be comparing the upcoming Tata Tiggo with its closest competitors, the Maruti Suzuki Dzire, the Hyundai Accent and the Honda Amaze. Performance and drivability. Tata has ensured that the Tiggo petrol seems quite evenly matched with its competitors on paper. However, on the road, it falls short of the competition, especially in terms of refinement, and is just not able to match the smooth and free-raving nature of its competitors' engines. The problem is that Honda's iVTEC, Suzuki's K12 and Hyundai's Kapa 2 are legendary powertrains, which have proven to be impossible to match even for giants like Volkswagen, Toyota and Ford. Tiggo has done a good job of matching them in terms of drivability though, with a 3-cylinder layout as opposed to their 4-cylinder configurations. However, Tiggo's 75 kg heavier curb weight gives it an added disadvantage over its rivals in terms of outright performance. The Tiggo diesel feels a bit outclassed compared to its rivals. Its 1050cc 3-cylinder engine and heavier curb weight is just no match to the higher displacement mills powering the competition. Tiggo is saddled with a fair bit of turbo lag at lower revs, requiring frequent gear shifts around town. Even on the highways, it quickly runs out of breath, requiring you to plan your overtaking maneuvers well in advance. It is over 50 Nm down compared to the Dzire, the upcoming Accent and the Amaze in terms of torque output. However, Tata has at least sound-deadened it to a notch above the Amaze and almost in line with the Dzire and the Accent. Fuel efficiency. The Tiggo has the highest certified ARAI mileage amongst the group. However, in the real world, it will actually turn out to be half a kmpl less efficient than its 1200cc engine rivals, going by what the Tiggo customers have been reporting on the forums. Handling and ride quality. Tata has built up a strong competency in the dynamics department with some of the best suspension setups of the segment as seen in the Zest, Bolt, Tiggo and Hexa. The best thing about recent Tata cars is that they have been extremely well suited for Indian road conditions with best-in-class ride quality without much of a compromise in handling. Their decent ground clearance, generous suspension travel and adequate tire size has proven to be just right for tackling broken and patchy road situations that we encounter so frequently in our country. The Tiggo is by far the best riding vehicle amongst the group, with a more pliant and comfortable ride compared to the Accent and the Amaze, and especially superior than the excessively stiff setup of the Dzire. It also handles much better than the Accent, matches the Amaze and is almost as good as the Dzire with an equally keen turn-in and a precise steering, but falls just short of the Dzire in terms of braking. Space and comfort. The Tiggo is not a typical Tata with acres of legroom and a rear seat big enough to accommodate 4 passengers occasionally. It is unexpectedly tight on space. Squeezing in a third passenger at the rear will make things uncomfortably tight on the Tiggo's second row. But then, the Amaze is just as tight in terms of rear seat space as the Tiggo. The Accent's rear seat is even narrower than the rest, making it a strict 2-seater. The Dzire is the tightest in terms of knee room, which coupled with the ultra-stiff ride makes it the last choice for rear seat occupants. Both the Accent and the Amaze have class-leading 400-liter boots. The Tiggo having a little bit smaller boot and the Dzire having the smallest boot with 316 liters of capacity. In terms of interior fit and finish, Tata has ensured that the Tiggo does not feel outclassed compared to its rivals and has even equipped it with features par for the segment. Reliability and after-sales service. Tiggo's biggest flaw is that it's a Tata. Both Hyundai and Honda have over 15 years of strong track record of making reliable vehicles in our country. Maruti Suzuki, as we all know, has not made an unreliable car for the longest time by far in a period spanning 4 decades in our country. Thanks to their inherent reliability and obsessive interference into service operations, the Japanese and the Koreans managed to have a firm grip on their service centers, leading to a hassle-free ownership experience extended to their satisfied customers. Tata, on the other hand, continues to struggle with niggling reliability issues and overlooks the dire state of affairs at its touch points. That brings us to the verdict. The Tiger is let down by two things. First is the choice of powertrains, which are still not in the same league as its well-entrenched rivals. And second is the terrible reputation of Tata Motors when it comes to quality, reliability, after-sale service and resale value. But don't write it off so soon. Tata may still have an ace up their sleeve in terms of pricing. Going by what they did with the Tiago, they just might scare the living daylights out of the competition by pricing it in line with the Celerio. Hit the subscribe button and click on the bell icon next to it to receive updates on Tiger's comparisons with more vehicles as soon as we make them live.